flow elements affect the flow of content on the page. Flow elements fall roughly into two basic categories. Block elements organize visual blocks of content. Examples include the P or paragraph and div or content division elements. The browser typically generates a line break to separate blocks, and each block element occupies the full horizontal space of its container element. Inline elements mark up a word, phrase, or other piece of text in line without breaking the flow of the content. The span, strong, and em, or emphasis, are examples of inline elements. With these elements, the browser does not generate a line break. Here are some best practices for using block elements. Select a semantic block element, such as header, main, or section, whenever its meaning makes sense. Use a P element when separating paragraphs of content. The div element is non-semantic, so it doesn't add any meaning to its content. Only use div when no semantic element makes sense. The div is best used for grouping content, often to style that group. Note that a div element can contain nested div elements as needed. When working with inline elements, select a semantic inline element, such as em for emphasis, strong for strong importance, and mark when highlighting, whenever that meaning makes sense. These are important to screen readers. For example, a screen reader will change their tone for strong text because it represents text that has strong importance. Don't use semantic elements just for styling. For example, don't use strong just to bold some text if that text doesn't have strong importance. The span element is non-semantic, so only use it when no semantic element makes sense. By itself, the span element doesn't do anything. Use span with CSS for styling a word or phrase of content. Let's try out div and span to better see the difference between block and inline elements. Open the Pet Cafe folder in VS Code. We'll edit the yoyo-detail.html file. In the My Story section, let's add a div element and some additional text. If I'm lonely, I meow loudly. Then a second div element and more text. When I'm hungry, I stand by my bowl. Click Go Live to bring up the browser and view the result. I'll reposition the windows and scroll down. Looking at the My Story section, notice the difference between the P and the div elements. The P element adds an empty line between the paragraphs. The div starts the content on a new line, but doesn't add empty lines between them. This is a great time to look at some additional developer tools. I'll make the browser full screen. Click the three dots in the upper right corner, select More Tools and Developer Tools, or simply press F12. Note that depending on your browser, the menu options may be different. For example, Safari has a develop menu at the top. The developer tool should open at the bottom or along the side of the browser. Click the Elements tab. The Elements tab displays all of the elements on the page. When you hover over an element in the tool, the browser highlights the element in the browser window. Click the arrows to view any nested content. Here's the header, main, and each of our sections. Let's scroll down the browser window. Then back in the Elements tab, let's look at the last section. Click the arrow to open it. Hover over any P element, and in the browser, we see the extra space before and after the element. Hover over the div element, and there is no extra space. This makes it clear how, by default, the P element is displayed differently from the div element. The Elements tab of the Developer Tools is also helpful if the page doesn't appear correctly, because it helps you see any mismatched tag pairs. Click the X here to close the Developer Tools, and I'll rearrange the windows. Before we move on, let's try out the EM and span tags. We'll add an EM around the word lonely. It automatically created the ending tag in the wrong spot. Drag lonely between the tags. add a span around I'm hungry, and it again generated the closing tag. Drag I'm hungry between the tags. Looking at the browser, we see that the EM element adds emphasis on lonely using italics. The span element has no effect, but we could use it for styling, as we'll see later in this series. Notice that neither element broke the flow of the text. Now let's change our two div elements to a single P element. I'll change the first div to a P here. Delete the closing tag here and the opening tag here. And let's not forget to change the closing tag here. Looking in the browser, we see the content appear as a single paragraph. We've now seen the difference between block and inline elements. Close the browser and close Live Server by clicking the port number here. Let's pop back to the slides. So, use a semantic block or inline element whenever the element's meaning makes sense. Recall that semantic refers to meaning. As we mark up our documents, we want that markup to provide as much meaning as possible so the browser understands what we want. The P element identifies a paragraph of text. By default, a paragraph is displayed on a separate line with an empty line between paragraphs. The div element represents a division in the content. It's a container to group other elements. By default, the div element contents are displayed on a separate line, but no empty line before or after. The div is often used for styling. Since div elements provide no semantic value, take care to use them only when no other semantic element makes sense. Use span to wrap words, phrases, or other inline content without breaking the flow. It's often used to style the wrapped content. We'll see more examples of div and span when we cover CSS later in this series. Let's move on to lists next.